Notice with this next slide that the source where I've obtained these two graphs is from the Energy Information Administration, particularly the International Energy Outlook for 2013. From that particular document, I've plucked two relevant graphs for us to examine. The first is Figure 140, World Energy-Related Carbon Dioxide Emissions, and Figure 141, World Energy-Related Carbon Dioxide Emissions by Fuel Type. The y-axis of Figure 140 measures carbon dioxide emissions in billion metric tons. So we have 10 billion metric tons, 20 billion metric tons, etc. And the x-axis has a time scale, and that's from 1990 to 2040. So we have some historical data and some data that's projected. We have two trend lines in 140. One is for OECD countries, and we see that that trend line is fairly flat. For non-OECD countries, however, we see that they exceeded the carbon dioxide emissions of OECD countries back in about, say, 2005. And going forward up to 2040, we see that non-OECD countries greatly exceed the carbon dioxide emissions compared to OECD countries. This is important because as we look at carbon mitigation strategies around the world, a question always comes up, well, who ought to be responsible? Should it be OECD countries who have a vast amount of their wealth and power and development built on the backs of carbon dioxide emissions? Or should it be non-OECD countries who have essentially are starting to catch up, you could say, to the OECD countries, and they are doing it on the low-hanging fruit, just as OECD countries did, that is using the fossil fuels, the coal, the petroleum and natural gas, the non-renewable resources that OECD countries found so easy and plentiful to use in order to spur on their development. This is an unresolved question, and it causes a lot of controversy. Figure 141 looks at world energy-related carbon dioxide emissions by fuel type. And again, we have on the y-axis billion metric tons, and we have 0 to 5 to 10, 20, etc., up to 25 billion metric tons. And we have the same temporal scale on the x-axis from 1990 to 2040. So we have then some historical data as well as some projected data. Notice that coal, liquid fuels, and natural gas are the three trend lines. The liquid fuels, that's basically petroleum products, and that's basically restricted to the transportation sectors around the world. But coal and natural gas, these are for energy generation, electricity generation. And so we see then that at current times, coal dominates the graph in terms of carbon dioxide emissions by fuel type, and then followed by liquid fuels, petroleum, products. And then at the bottom we have natural gas. So we see then that currently coal is responsible for more carbon dioxide emissions than liquid fuels and also than natural gas. This is very important also because as countries and states and provinces around the world consider what their future generation capacity ought to be, the question always comes up, well, should we consider burning more coal or should we consider burning more natural gas? Given that coal is responsible for more carbon dioxide emissions than natural gas, many places are choosing to go with natural gas rather than with coal. Another factor is economics with this. Natural gas, particularly because of hydraulic fracturing as well as horizontal drilling, has become incredibly plentiful and cheap, particularly in North America, relative to where it was even, say, 5 to 10 years ago. And so we have two variables there that are important in the consideration of building a coal-fired power plant versus a natural gas-fired power plant. In 2011, the world had 3,496,000 megawatts of fossil fuel generating capacity. You know particularly that I don't particularly like the term fossil fuel, but I'm using it here because this statement is drawn right from the EIA's data, and they use the term fossil fuel, and it's very common to use that. So what I've done in this slide is examine a 500 megawatt coal-fired power plant, and compared it to a 500 megawatt gas-fired power plant. And the reason we're doing that is because we want to see how much carbon dioxide each one will emit in a year. Now, we know that coal-fired power plants have an emission rate of approximately 2,249 pounds per megawatt hour. And gas-fired power plants have a CO2 emission rate of approximately 1,135 pounds of CO2 per megawatt hour. So we're looking at then a 500 megawatt coal-fired power plant and a 500 megawatt gas-fired power plant. And we're asking the question then, well, how much carbon dioxide should we expect to be emitted into the air after a year of operations in the coal-fired and in the gas-fired power plants? So we go through a set of very simple calculations. First, we take the capacity of each plant, 500 megawatts, and notice it's the same for each plant. And we multiply that by 24 hours, and we then multiply that by the capacity factor. And we see for coal, that capacity factor is 0.576, and for gas, that capacity factor is 0.511. So fairly close, but not exactly the same. This is the same procedure we've gone through in a previous presentation. And we see that for the coal-fired power plant, we can expect 6,804 megawatt hours generated per day, and for the gas-fired, about 6,132 megawatt hours per day. If we then multiply those megawatt hours by the expected emission rate for coal, 2,249 pounds, we see that the coal-fired power plant in one day will emit 15,302,196 pounds of carbon dioxide. Now, 15,302,196 is a large number, and it's a lot easier to work with smaller numbers. So we simply can divide this then by what's called a short ton, which we know as just simply a ton, and that's 2,000 pounds. So we're going to divide that large number, 15,302,196, by 2,000. And we see that a 500 megawatt coal-fired power plant will emit 7,651 tons of carbon dioxide per day. If we multiply that by 365 days, we get how much it emits in a year. And that is 2,792,615 tons of carbon dioxide per year. Many times, we simply simplify this and say that a 500 megawatt coal-fired power plant, on average, will emit about 3 million tons of carbon dioxide per year. That's a fairly common statement in much of the industry. And this is a modest-sized power plant. If we follow the same procedure with the gas-fired power plant, looking at the emissions of 1,135 pounds per megawatt hour, we see then that we get a number that's considerably less, and it's considered about half, but there's some wiggle room in there. But at the very end of these calculations, following the same procedure we did for coal, we see that gas-fired power plants emit 1,270,200 tons of carbon dioxide per year. And this is, again, about half. So when we consider the previous slide, we see that there are billions of tons of carbon dioxide being emitted into the air, and here we see why. We just have two very modest-sized power plants here. Both of them burn fossil fuels, and both of them emit considerably large amounts of carbon dioxide into the atmosphere. It's little wonder, then, that the y-axis on the previous slide has to be in billions of tons, because consider the top of this slide, the world has 3,496,000 megawatts of generating capacity, basically based on coal and natural gas.